welcome back to my channel. So today is an amazing day. It's an amazing day because the Queen of Rap has just broken another record. I mean, we do this every day. It's pretty straightforward at this point. Nicki Minaj has become the first female rapper this century to debut at number one on the Hot 100. She has set the record for a female rapper debuting at number one on the Hot 100. And I just want to take a moment to just rest in peace everyone who used to try and drag my good sis for not having a number one record. I just want to take a moment for all of you. I want to ask, are you okay? Are you all right? How are you feeling emotionally? Because it's queen things. It's just queen things. It's queen things only in the kingdom. I want to play this message from Nicki.
A moment for the Barbz.
I fly with the stars in the skies. I am no longer trying to survive. I believe that life is a prize, but to live doesn't mean you're alive. Don't worry about me and who I fire. I get what I desire. It's my empire. And yes, I call the shots. I am the umpire. I sprinkle holy water.
No, I'm not done. Cause I came out 09 when promoters brought Wayne out. Lewinsky, like I couldn't get the stain out. I've been bad, like cutting school and staying out. I've been hotter than vacation and laying out. I sat back and watched how it's playing out. They diss me, but running just like the same round. But no, they not Nicki. Wrist on ice, and yes, my wrist bricky. If I leave, the game will miss Nicki. Not a website, but get money, this is 50. Pop bottles with my bitches and get pissy. This shit ain't got no more integrity. Don't write they raps, and plus they flow shitty. Don't make me expose you, bitch, I'm too busy. Hopped on the bridge. New York City, niggas to the queen, niggas all witty.
I'm gonna be a Barb, honestly, forever. I'm so proud to stand. Now let's get back to the video.
I just wanna make this 150,000% clear. No one does Nicki Minaj numbers. No one does numbers in the context that Nicki Minaj does numbers. No one does numbers in the context where an industry actively doesn't want you to do any numbers. No one does numbers where you get no radio play, no playlisting. Those two things are so integral.
Barbs, y'all did this with no playlisting and no radio. And it's just not happening in 2020. All the records on the top of the chart right now are doing that with heavy playlisting and heavy radio. So for us to do that debuting, that's insane. So I love you guys so much. We just did the highest pure sales of the year of every song released. And you can't buy that. That's fan love. It's a couple things I want to get off my chest, though. Certain things that have been going on in this industry for just way too long. I think it's time for me to speak on it a little bit. But in the meantime, y'all know 6ix9ine going to be doing a lot this week, too. So be prepared for that. I love you so fucking much.
Think about it like this. If you're watching this video, you're likely to have seen this video in one of three ways. One, I posted it on my personal social media channel, so you're a friend, you want to support me, so you watched my video and that's why you're here. Shout out to you. Or secondly, you saw this video because you subscribed to my channel. Maybe you watched some other videos of mine and so you decided that, hey, I think she's cool, I'll subscribe. And then you gave this video a shot when you saw it because maybe you know that I like Nicki Minaj, or maybe because you were bored and you wanted to watch it. The point is, in the first two instances, I've already captured you. So if you take the concept of a captured audience and you apply that back to rap and hip hop, who is a captured audience in 2020? How many artists have audiences that are already hooked? That whatever they drop, they're gonna listen, they're gonna buy. That's where stans come in. So if you look at stans, you can see, okay, stans are more than just a captured audience. Stans are going to stream, they're going to purchase, they're going to buy, they're going to be strategic about making sure that their favorite artist charts well. People who don't have stans have radio and they have playlisting. Now, what does radio and playlisting do that stans don't? Radio and playlisting says, hey, we know that you've signed up to, you know, turn on the radio today and listen to some music. And we've already decided the music that you're going to listen to. And as long as we decide to play this music to you, this artist is going to get a lot of credit because this song has been played on radio. Similarly, with playlisting, it's the radio of the streaming world. With playlisting, you get big streaming providers on platforms like Spotify. Spotify says, hey, we'll put your album or your new single on some playlists. People already listen to these playlists, so they're gonna listen to them anyway. You're not able to edit the playlist. You're not able to remove songs from the playlist. So if the song is on the playlist, more often than not, you're gonna listen to that song. So it works in a similar way to radio. So you can see how without a stan base, you can still have massive, massive reach because your songs are being curated and played and credited for their plays for an audience that has done nothing except for turn on the radio or play a playlist. So you are getting the benefit of a massive audience through strategic positioning of your work. Whereas with stans couldn't care less whether or not the song has been put onto a playlist. That's not what's going to make the stan listen. The stan is going to listen because it's your music. And therefore, because it's your music, they're going to buy it, they're going to stream it, they're going to make sure that you chart. Whereas with radio play and playlisting, it's just an audience that isn't really trying to find you, but if they do, they'll listen. How do you get those numbers? How do you get those Billboard numbers? The only way you get Billboard numbers is by having a massive, massive amount of sales, radio play, and streams. The thing that artists like Nicki Minaj don't have consistently is radio play. Radio play counts massively to these charts that you see. So if Nicki doesn't have radio play, she's left with streams and sales. And that's where stans come in, because stans will stream and they will buy. So you don't have the radio playlist audience, but you have the stands and streams. Sorry. You don't have the radio and playlist audience, but you have the streams and the buying audience. And what that gives you is numbers. And that is what Nicki has shown. Nicki has strength in numbers. So when Nicki says something like, you know, check the charts, check the boards, I'm still topping, that means that her stands are in full effect. And I want to give a credit to the Nicki fans. You know, the stands did this. The stands did this, you know, and 6ix9ine's got his own stands too, but the stands did this. So I want you to get it clear that it's not easy to achieve what Nicki's achieved, and it's because she's got a dedicated, loyal stan base. It's absolutely not because she has been supported by the industry as a whole. Convinced at this point that there is nothing that Nicki Minaj cannot do. I've been convinced of that for a while. I'm really just trying to enjoy life. I'm trying to enjoy the queen. I'm trying to enjoy the new music. I'm just really excited and proud. It's a great time to be a Barb. That's all I'll say. But it's a great time. It's a great time. You know, it's just, it's lovely when you really support someone and you get to see them shining and thriving. And shining and thriving she is. Nicki's doing really well, and I'm really, really proud of her. So shout out to you, Queen. Shout out to the Barbz. This video was hella chaotic, but you know, I think we addressed the main points. And follow No Ghostwriter, No _ Ghostwriter on Twitter and Instagram for 24/7 rap and hip hop talk. And yeah, I'ma see you guys when I see you next time Queen goes number one, which will probably be next week because it be like that. But yeah, shout out to Nicki, shout out to the Barbz. It's just, yeah, everyone did amazingly this week. And we love you, Queen. And you're the queen of hip hop. And we love you. Peace out.